could figure out an antiderivative for log x by just guessing and then checking our answer, but we can also get that antiderivative by using integration by parts. So I want to know an antiderivative of log x dx. And just to remind you, this is natural log. At first, it looks like there's nothing helpful here. What will my u and my dv be? The trick is to set u log x, that's the part of the integrand I'm going to differentiate, and then set dv to be dx, which I think is quite surprising. And that helps. Well, let's see. So if u is log x, then du is 1 over x dx. And if dv is dx, then an antiderivative just be x. Now what does parts tell us? So by parts, the integral of u dv, so log x dx, that's what I'm interested in, is uv, so x log x, minus the integral of v du, which is x times du. But now I've got x log x minus x times 1 over x, that's just 1. So I'm just antidifferentiating dx. And I've got x log x, what's an antiderivative of 1? Just x, and I'll add a constant. So I'm claiming that the antiderivative of log x is x log x minus x plus some constant. I think it's really surprising that, at least in this case, dv equals dx is a great choice. Well, here's a similar integration problem that you can try the same kind of technique on. For example, here's a challenge. Can you find an antiderivative of log of x squared?